हाँ
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच, हाउ टू राइट अ डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच। यस ओके, सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच, एंड सेकंड वी हैव टू लर्न इन द एंड ऑफ दिस lecture we have to be able to get a knowledge how to write direct and indirect speech. Then we have to know that how to accurate punctuate the direct and indirect speech, and know when and how to change pronouns and verb tenses in indirect speech. Okay, now do we learn about the direct speech. When we use direct speech in our writing, we have to the exact words which the speaker spoke, that we have to write into double inverted comma. Then we have to, in the direct speech, the first spoken word must have be in the capital letter in the direct speech. And when the new speaker begins in the direct speech, we must start a new line. Now the direct speech, we will see the some examples of the direct speech. Here you can see how the direct speech is there. Okay, next. Okay, see, I have heard my name, mourned the boy. Okay, in this double inverted comma, the direct speech which is written, I have heard my name, mourned the boy. The boy is mourned when his leg hurt. So it is said direct speech. I have hurt my leg. Next. You can see here also, can you take a deep breath? Ask the doctor. When you go to visit the doctor, now doctor is asking directly to the patient that can you take a deep breath? This is also a direct speech. It is the example of the direct speech. Next. Again here it is. I like this dress. The woman says, I like this dress. She is buying a dress in shop, and now she is saying that the woman said, "I like this dress." This is also a example of direct speech. Okay, here we can see the how we have to punctuation the direct speech. So there is a, when we are using the direct speech, there is a punctuation marks we have to be made there. So for example, we can take here, I have got 3 fish. Then again, I am a clever girl. Then I love ice cream. Do you know what type of anger this is? The train will leave in 10 minutes. So every example, there is a different punctuation marks. For example, do you know what type of anger this is? This is a question mark. So we have to add the question mark is also there in the double inverted comma. I have got 3 fish. There is a full stop. We have to write in the double inverted comma. Again, I am a clever girl. She is saying about herself. It is also we have to write in the double inverted comma. Next slide, please. Now we will see about the indirect speech. How we have to write the indirect speech. In the indirect speech, there is also called a reported speech. Direct speech, in the direct speech, there is a reported verb also is there, and reporting speech is also there. In the direct and indirect speech, these two parts is most important. That is the reported verb and that is the reported speech. Reported verb means here who said to whom. For example, the teacher said to students. This is who said to whom. And in the, what is the reported speech? In the reported speech, the teacher said to students, go to the class. This is go to the class. This is called a reported speech. Reported speech always written in the double inverted comma. Now, indirect speech. This is sometimes we call a reported speech also. And in writing the reported speech, how we write the direct speech? We never write the same in the indirect speech. We never use the speech marks also there. In the direct speech, we use the speech mark, that is the double inverted comma. But here, we not use that. Again, we usually have to change pronouns and verb tenses. In the direct speech, what is the tense is there? What is the verb of that direct speech? we always have to change that verb in according to the tenses in the reported speech or indirect speech. We don't have to start a new line when we report a new speaker's verbs. Okay, this is also we have to make it taking in account that in direct speech we not have to start a new line when we start a new speaker's verbs. Okay, now we will take some examples of the indirect speech. Okay, now these are the reporting statements where there are the some examples which is in the direct speech and some examples which is in the reported speech. Now we will see here. For example, I like techno music. He informed me. He informed me. Here you can see that I like techno music. He informed me. Here you can see that there is a double inverted comma is there. Again, same sentence. He is in the indirect speech. That he informed me that he liked techno music. In this reported speech, we have to translate the verb and also according to the tenses. For example, here you can see that I like. In the like, there is a present tense. We translate that into past tense. So that is the liked. Again, we can see the are dancing. They are dancing very well. She agreed. They are dancing very well. Same sentence we translate into indirect speech. That is, she agreed that they were dancing very well. We have to be clear here that in the direct speech, the speaker directly speaks, and in indirect speech, when the speaker is speaking, that time the speaker have to see there. She agreed that we have to the inverted comma, double inverted comma, that sentence. And who speaks? We have to connect that two lines into that word. She agreed that. Now we have to translate the in the reported speech, that sentence we have to translate according to the tenses. See here, they were, here is. In the direct speech there is a are. So in the indirect speech we have to translate that into past tense. That is the were. They were dancing very well. Again, we can see the next example. That is, we bought tickets yesterday. They explained. Someone explained. Someone is saying that. Someone is explaining something. What is explaining? That they explained. What explained? We bought tickets yesterday. This we bought tickets yesterday. It is written in the double inverted comma, and they explained. Now we have to translate this sentence into indirect. How we can translate? See here. They explained that. We have to add. We have to connect those two sentences into that word. That they had bought tickets the day before. Here you can see a had bought. Okay, bought. Which is in the past tense. So we have to translate that into the again. Had bought tickets the day before. We translate this according to the tenses. Firstly, when we have to translate the direct speech into indirect speech, we have to know about the tenses very well. And when we understand what kind of tense is used in the direct speech, according to that tense, we have to translate that. Next example, I have never been here before. Tom declared. Tom is declared that. He declared. He has never been there. He never visited that place. So he declared. What he declared? I have never been here. Before, I have never been here. So same sentence translated into reported speech. That is, the Tom declared that. We have to what, who said to whom? Who is saying? That speaker and what he said. That we have to. Here again we have to connect in the that. Always we have to use this that word in the indirect speech. Tom declared that he had never been there before. Again, you can see the another examples. That I was listening to the music. She told us I was listening to the music. Again, we have to translate this into reported speech, or we can say that indirect speech. Well, she told us that she had been listening to the music. Again, next example, we will be here tomorrow. They promise. promised. We will be here. We will be here tomorrow. They promised. They promised that they would be here the next week. You can see the difference here. Okay. Now we what we did. We then we have to translate the direct speech into indirect speech. We connect the two sentences into that word. Again we changes the tenses also. But here what kind of a word is used here? Tomorrow. But when we translate into indirect speech, the tomorrow also change. We not use the tomorrow here. For tomorrow we use the word the next day. The next day. We have to change also here. Again, the next example is the young people must learn to behave. He said that young people have to learn to behave. Again, the next example, we can go to the festival. He explained that we could go to the festival. I may visit you tomorrow, he said. He said he might visit you the next day. He said he might. Again, you can he may. May we can change into might. Again here can we change it into could. So in the direct speech we are the speaker is directly speaking to another person. What he is saying he directly told to another person. But in the indirect speech someone is saying that person is saying something, and that we third person, what that person is saying, we explain that into our language. So it is when we have to tell the story about something. So that time what we used, if the story is myself, so we use the direct speech. I use that direct speech and I will tell the story. But I want to tell you the story which someone told me. So that time we have to use the indirect speech. Okay, now thank you.